Asta, and this is my lovely guest panel.
Michael Howe.
Chandler Rack.
Clarissa Bustamante.
And first up tonight, we're going to be talking about the top five box office hits. At number one was Dumb and Dumber 2, which, who could have guessed it? It was awesome. At number two is Big Hero 6. At number three was Interstellar. At number four, Beyond the Lights. And at number five, Gone Girl, which they've been up for a while, so that's good for them. Okay, and now we're going to be talking about the shows coming up. First up is The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1, which we will be discussing later in more terms.
I'm really so excited
about that.
Yeah, that looks really good.
But yeah, second thing we'll be talking about is The Sleepwalker. How did you guys feel about that one?
I'm excited, honestly. It's like a Sundance film, so it's kind of like an indie, a little bit different, difference in the box office. So,
see, I am completely different. I saw the trailer. I was like watching it, and I mean, it's Stephen King. It should be kind of creepy, kind of eerie, but I don't really I just don't really get the gist of it. It doesn't really make much sense.
Yeah, I'm with her on that. I watched the trailer, and I didn't really get it. Like, there was like, it seemed just like, you thought something was gonna happen through it, like the whole time.
Yeah, that never happened.
Yeah. And it was just like, oh, she's just like walking into a place and
Stephen King should be good though. I'm excited about that. I mean
he's
really,
usually a good guy. Yeah. He's usually a good writer and everything.
Well,
but
and it's definitely one of those movies where it's like you watch it and then you're like, what just happened? It's one of those things where you have to talk to people afterwards to like figure out exactly what happened.
Yeah. Sure. I mean, those are like a kind of movies. I mean, Gone Girl, that was something that I know I was like, I kept rethinking about the different outcomes in different ways, and that's like definitely, you don't see that in movies anymore. Mm-mm. So,
no, no, I totally agree on that. It's an indie film, so of course it's gonna like get
gonna
you to keep
different.
Guessing.
Yeah,
and
it's gonna be a little bit different.
Well, okay, well, definitely different. next up, we will be talking about the VHS viral video that's coming out.
I don't know. That's really weird to me. The whole social media aspect of it and stuff. Like, it's just really, I don't know how to feel about it.
Handheld movies also give me a headache.
Yeah.
So.
I don't like the shaky
cam. The use of
camera.
The shaky cam, the way, like, Paranormal Activity and the Blair Witch Project, all of that sort of thing.
Yeah. They're, like, they're trying, so it's, like, a social media kind of orient with it. Basically, they're trying to make, like, the scariest horror movie ever. So it's just, like, a bunch of, like, these VHSs, like, combined to this, like, super scary thing. So it's like a different cinematography thing, but they really make VHSs look bad. Like, I remember watching a VHS and, like, okay, it was not like that, whatever.
Right,
like,
definitely
for sure.
Not.
I mean, I think
us 90 kids, we know.
Like horror films, you know? I mean, there's always that kind of like shaky, like what's happening next? Mm-hmm. Like, oh, like it's shaking and all of a sudden something pops out. There's so many different demonic entities and scary things that pop out in every single one of those little clips of the tapes.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oh, yeah. While watching that, like, I haven't done this in a long time while watching a trailer, but I actually was just. I didn't, it scared the crap out of me. Yeah. Like, I did not want to know what was coming next.
I was on the edge of my seat the entire time.
I also feel like those kind of movies are a little overdone, too. Like, the shaky camera. Like,
yeah, it's
like,
almost
you know,
like it's too much. There's too much going on at once.
Exactly.
You're just like, okay, I want to either focus on the scary movie or I want to focus on the shaky camera, but not both.
Makes my head I think it was like a Halloween reject, you know? Like, it tried to come out.
Speaking of like, like a Halloween reject thing. Extraterrestrial, like that movie that's coming out. It's like, the spaceship comes, lands there. It's just this whole. It's not like E.T. It's not, you know.
It's like the unfriendly, like the not children-friendly version of E.T.
The scarier version.
Oh yeah, they're just like abducting up humans for like experimental reasons, which is like that could happen. I mean, who are we to think that we are the only beings on this planet?
Yeah.
Right.
Well, on this planet, I mean, in the universe, my bad.
I mean, it's a huge place. I mean, there's been theories, and it's actually been talked about a lot recently before this video. A lot of articles have been saying that, you know, there is other life forms, and other like scholarly articles have been saying stuff. So.
Well, and another thing is that it shows like there's a connection between the government and the extraterrestrials. Like there's some type of agreement between them, which is really strange to think about that there's something that we don't know and that's something that they're already
that the government could
taken
like,
care of, I, supposedly. Right. Yeah. Supposedly taken care of already.
Like, okay, sorry. This is like, it kind of reminds me of like Cabin in the Woods, if you guys have seen
that.
Yes. Where, like, it was like the government has like these deal with like these supernatural scary ass things. Yeah. And like, it's weird, but extraterrestrial. Like, do you guys think
it's another one of those movies that just makes you jump?
Honestly, it could either be something that could be amazing and never done before, or it could be overdone.
Are there any good like actors in it? Like, are there any big
names? There's no.
I don't think so. Absolutely not. So there's nothing that's gonna pull it up. You know, usually if it's a movie that's maybe good or maybe not good, they'll have like a star-studded cast. That
like Interstellar with Matthew McConaughey.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Yeah.
They're relying a lot on the storyline on this, so we'll see.
Well, hopefully it's good.
Yeah. Okay. So what about Horrible Bosses 2?
Wait, nope. Sucks.
Really? Mm-hmm. I'm pumped.
I thought it was going to be so funny.
It kind of looks like a little bit of a Hangover type of movie. With like the three men just kind of running around trying to figure out what's going on.
I like Charlie Day. Like I like It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, but like I don't know, I just didn't like Horrible Bosses for some reason.
I like the first one. The first one was really great, and so I think the second one will be just as good, honestly.
I love how they brought Jennifer Aniston back. Yeah. She is as hot as ever, brunette, rocking.
Does she ever age? I don't get that.
Is she dating? Is she dating that one guy?
Oh, goodness. Are you looking to date her?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I would.
any movie with Jennifer Aniston, honestly, she is such a key actress. And
she's
Jamie
really good,
Foxx,
yeah.
You know, he's just a guy, like, you know, doesn't give a crap.
He's got, like, the brain tattoo on him. Exactly. He looks so dope. Like, he's so awesome.
We can't forget about Jason Sudeikis, too. He's on SNL, so we know he's proven many times to be hilarious.
Yes.
So
mm-hmm.
He's definitely a big part of this movie, too.
Oh, definitely.
I definitely see it. I think it's one for the viewing. I think it's going to be a good, funny kind of
spin. I completely agree.
I completely agree with that as well. Okay. Now let's talk about The Imitation Game, which is this new movie coming up. What's his name? Benedict Cumberbatch. He was like the lead guy from Sherlock Holmes, whatever. And he's in it. It's like this like new British show. Keira Knightley's in it. It was pretty awesome and everything.
Yeah.
It looks super action packed.
Yeah, it really
it's a historical
thriller. It looks like a good storyline. It looks
really
like a classic.
Mm-hmm. The Sherlock Holmes show is really good.
Yeah. The cinematography looks really good. Just watching the trailer, everything, the lighting, and it looks very classy, very old timey. Things like that.
For sure.
Oh, yeah. And I think the idea of it, too, draws a lot of people in because people love to hear about World War II and the Nazis and, you know, kind of all of the underlying everything that happens. So, having a movie be based on that, I think, is a really
exactly the whole plot is just like helping to crack, helping to crack Germany's Nazi code, which is like something so interesting.
Definitely
to see how everything rolls out.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay. Well, we're gonna head out to commercial break. You stay tuned. We'll be right back.
And I know you won't tell what I said, 'cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
Survive, but I mean, I think it's just kind of worn its welcome. You know? I mean, there's a fan base for it, but I think it's just kind of overdone. Like 8 or 9, like I mean, that's a little much.
I don't. Three is good.
Yeah, three was good.
I'm just so torn when movies go like
when
all
it
the
hits
way
after
though.
Like five or after three.
Five is even a little.
I mean,
too much
when
on
we're going
one.
All the way up to nine.
Nine, yeah, it's a
like
little,
maybe
it's a little
maybe
much.
Eight will work, maybe, but nine. I'm not sure. I feel like that's just pushing the envelope a little
bit. I almost feel like it's a little, like, almost disrespectful that they're kind of keeping going without, like, Paul Walker in it. I mean.
They're
going
to put his brother in the place, right? Cody Walker?
No, they're not, okay. You know. Oh. But, I mean, that would have been a really great idea, definitely.
Yeah.
But.
I mean, I think it still looks like a good movie. All the Fast and Furiouses are very action-packed.
Definitely.
I mean, yeah, if you like
there's
that
a lot
movie,
going
I mean,
on.
It's perfect for, like, action.
But then again, it's like you've seen it.
Yeah, 1,000
a million
times,
and one times.
Yes.
I mean, Star Wars is up to 7, so I mean, Fast and Furious, I think they're just trying to up them on that.
But
honestly,
Fast and Furious is definitely not on the level of Star Wars.
Yeah.
Well, of course.
Agreed.
But yeah, no, they've both like gone on pretty long and everything, so
I mean,
we'll
Vin
see.
Diesel in it, he, I just like
he's
him personally.
Stud.
He is a straight up just jive.
Yeah, he's a jive mama jamma right there.
I'd have to say so. Any movie he's in, you're just like, all right, it's going down. Like, he knows what's going down.
Okay.
He's a good actor. He's great.
Okay. Well, now let's talk about Lifetime biographies, which first off, we can talk about Aaliyah. The title of that is Princess of R&B. What do you guys feel about that? I heard it didn't get up to
it. It tanked,
great start.
Honestly. It was terrible. I haven't seen or heard one good review about it. It looks like almost everybody in the media is in agreement that it was bad. A lot of people think it was disrespectful. The parents, honestly, I don't think they wanted a documentary on her. They didn't even release the rights to her music to be played in the movie. So
That kind of like kills the purpose of it
definitely.
Too.
I think they would have gotten the hint.
It had the highest viewership, right though?
It had the second highest viewership with like 3 million views. So it got like great viewership,
but then bad reviews.
Exactly. I think everyone was really excited about it. Everybody wanted to watch it because Aaliyah, I mean, she died in 2001. She was only 22. She was like the Britney Spears of R&B.
Right.
Everybody wanted to see what her life is about, and then they see this, and they're just really disappointed about it.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, just having a family conflict also, if your parents are like not wanting to release any information about you or wanting a biography about yourself, I feel like it would just be kind of defeating the purpose of having the video itself.
It's like, that was my kid.
Well, exactly. And like, they went through all these different cast members, like Zendaya from Shake It Up was supposed to play it. Yeah. And then she felt a lot of pressure from Aaliyah's parents because they thought she wasn't right. So she had to drop out.
No one's going to be good.
Well, exactly. And then.
Who was their star?
Oh, crap.
The main actress.
I'm not sure.
I don't think it was.
It was the parents weren't okay with that actor actress either.
No.
But she continued to do it. So I mean, I guess props for her for sticking to it.
I think her name is Alexis something. Alexander Ship? Alexander Ship?
That sounds familiar. I know it started with an A.
Yeah.
That's definitely.
I mean, that just goes to show how much we know and care about that movie. So.
Yeah. Well, it's made for a reason, ladies and gentlemen. You heard it here. Okay. So speaking of like Lifetime documentaries and stuff, what about like the Brittany Murphy story? Like, they've done a lot about it.
I mean, that could be good. I mean, it's a Lifetime.
I think it's interesting. I mean, it'd be dramatic because, like you said, it's Lifetime. Yeah, yeah. But I mean. The drug overdose and the conflict.
Yeah,
of
there's
what it is.
Yeah, conflict like that. People don't want to really believe. My roommate doesn't believe that she like died of like suicide or whatever, like by her own means. It was like environmental, like a murder kind of thing. Because her husband kind of died like the same way.
Right.
There's definitely something fishy in there. Like there's something strange about the fact that they both died in the same way.
A conspiracy.
I
think that's a little old.
It could be like maybe like carbon monoxide.
Yeah,
like maybe. I mean, something in the walls.
I think it was suicide.
Dying the same way. Same place.
I mean, unless the husband just couldn't live without her and just wanted to die in the exact same, like a Romeo and Juliet kind of
situation. I honestly suggested that too. Yeah.
The options are endless. I mean, we don't really know. All we can do is guess.
Yeah.
Only speculate.
I mean,
I
know there's another one, Anna Nicole.
Yeah.
She was more famous than she was actually famous. She was like that. She was like this well-endowed bombshell type of lady. Okay, well, if you don't know a lot about her, then it's.
No, she was great. She was a great, attractive, awesome, like great celebrity. A lot of people liked her, so.
I think. Actually, Panic at the Disco used her like image on one of their like covers, like in
Wait,
a little.
Yeah,
like,
you're so.
That's
right.
The only reason. No, why
you're so right. I totally remember that happening. I know what you're talking about.
Into my life. Yeah. Well, and another Lifetime documentary one with the Casey Anthony.
That's.
Yeah.
That's a
messed
up
story. She did it.
We know she did it.
There's no other way they can spin it. No matter, even if they tried to make the movie look like she wasn't guilty, she's still guilty. Like everything, if they're gonna use real facts.
She didn't act like how a freaking mother should after their baby
she
died.
She was out partying, right?
Yeah, she was out partying like the next weeks or whatever.
No, it was completely a messed up situation. Chloroform in a house, looking up how to bury a body.
Yeah, bury a body.
Okay. At least find your facts.
Not looking
well, honestly, I feel like if it honestly wasn't her, she would have called someone, maybe called the police, like maybe been worried a little bit.
Yeah,
loving, like
you know.
It's your baby.
You know, the only way like people started looking into it and everything was because she was like disconnected from her parents or whatever. Like she didn't have a good like relationship with them, but the grandma was wanting to like, you know, I want to see my grandbaby, whatever, but she kept making up excuses the whole time.
So she was hiding something.
Oh, yeah.
There was something definitely fishy the whole time.
Okay, well, no more Lifetime now. We're going to be
Lifetime movies. Lifetime's sad.
They give me so much anxiety, honestly. I can't watch them.
My heart can't take it. Okay. All right, now Netflix. We're going to be talking about like a web video program, kind of like a little rivalry thing that's going on with that. Netflix, they've got their originals, like for example, one is House of Cards.
Orange is the New
political
Black.
Show.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, Orange is the New Black and Hemlock Grove. Okay, so House of Cards, do you guys have anything to add on that one?
I've seen the first season, it's really good. Sometimes it can be a little dry though. For me, at least.
It's like, not it's something I would watch, you know, if I'm just like kicking back, you know. It's not something I'd watch
show.
For entertainment.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. It's highly rated among like all the political shows and everything. So
definitely.
Good for them. Not my cup of tea.
Exactly.
An intense
great acting. I heard great acting.
Yeah, for sure.
So go Netflix on that one. And then now Orange is the New Black, which okay,
big
so
fan.
I like that. I'm so into that. It's about Piper. It's actually based off a true story, which, she admits to, like, this murder, goes to jail and all this kind of stuff, and meets some interesting people along the way. Who was it that dressed up as Crazy Eyes for Halloween? Do you guys know?
I think it was
Julian Hough, and it was like...
Oh, that's awesome.
I think...
Did you guys see that? It was really controversial.
She dressed up as who? Is it Crazy Eyes?
Like she's like... They're her, right there.
Yeah, her.
Yeah. So what she did was she like darkened her skin, which was like controversial and everything like that.
Always the black paint's always very like
never.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't like black paint. It was more like a really dark, like really dark tan.
Yeah.
Like you know what I was saying, kind of thing. But that was controversial. But I honestly thought it like it was funny. Like she did a good.
I don't have a problem with it, I guess.
I mean, hey, good for her. Katy Perry was a Cheeto, so, I mean.
Yeah, flame hot Cheeto.
I don't know what these stars are doing anymore.
And the thing is that she rocked it, which was just crazy.
Katy Perry rocks anything, so.
That's true. Yeah, she does.
Okay, well, all right. Now we should probably get back to Netflix. We're going to be talking about the next show on Netflix is Hemlock Grove, which is another Netflix original. How do you guys feel about that one? I know it's vampires, werewolves.
I feel like everything's vampire,
yeah,
werewolf
I'm kind
now.
Of a little sick of that.
It's overdone like, a little
vampire
bit.
Vampire Diaries,
yeah.
Twilight.
I'm okay with the main character, though. He played Declan on Degrassi,
and I
think he's so cute.
Yeah, I agree. It's more of like a badass version of like werewolves and vampires because... You know how you're used to seeing like the love story kind of thing?
Like the romanticized.
This is like showing more of like the
like
scary
grittier,
side.
Like
right.
Scarier.
It's definitely
okay.
eerie.
So I guess you guys should probably give it a shot. I don't know.
I mean,
I'll watch it
for the boy. I'll watch it for him. But that's
I mean, yeah,
that's about
the boy
it.
You can always watch it for. That's probably what I would watch it for because I get scared of even American Horror Story or like...
Things
like
that.
Oh, I love American Horror Story.
I know.
No,
too scary for me.
The clowns. I can't
the
do it.
I just.
Okay. Well, we should probably like stick to topic. All right. Well, since we're talking about like the web programs, we can talk about Amazon Instant Video, which is again in rivalry with like Netflix, and they've got some originals too. Go figure now. One being Alpha House. Have you guys heard of that one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I heard it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Get it? Yeah.
Just well, average, that's what I've heard.
Yeah.
Kinda.
Okay,
nothing
well.
Too crazy, nothing
yeah.
too.
No, yeah. They also had like Betas, Mozart's of the Jungle, The After.
I think I've ever heard of that one.
The After. Yeah, it's basically another like post-apocalyptic like drama
okay.
thing.
Yeah.
So it's with like eight strangers and they're like going and they're like trying to, I know, like survive in this world. Like,
oh, that story's so overdone.
I know.
It's just something else.
It is.
Come up with new ideas.
Originality. That's
what I have to tell them.
Well, that's what everyone's into nowadays. We need some drama in our lives.
I took a lot of boring lives.
All right. And so now that we talked about Netflix and Amazon, there is Hulu Plus. And Hulu Plus is, we got some originals with that. It's The Misfits, which is a British TV show.
I like British. I like British accents.
They're
fine with me. I enjoy them.
The accents. It's kind of like similar to like Skin, sort of. It's basically about like a, well, not really, but it has a lot of like personality characteristics. It's like a group of young offenders and they're sentenced to like community service. And then, like, an electrical storm gives them
Kind of looks like right now.
I think that main actor's on Game of Thrones.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, I think so. I think this guy that plays Ramsay. Yeah, him right there.
Oh, well, it looks like he is making.
Yeah, well, they get superpowers after this electrical storm. You can see him like freaking out about it.
Yeah. Jeez. Oh. All right. Well, yeah. You know what? This looks like really interesting. I don't know.
I mean, it looks like an action-packed show if you're into that sort of thing. So.
Okay. Well, I
guess I'll give it a watch.
I guess I have to watch that.
All right. Well, we're gonna head out to commercial. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look.
Welcome back to Razorback Reels. This half of the show, we're going to be talking about The Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 1, which they're doing like two parts of it. Is that wise or?
I think it's pretty wise. They can put more of the book into like each part. I mean,
I'd rather them do that than skimp out on some of like the main details, because I know I read all three books and I'd be very upset if they left out certain things.
Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah. And it gives you like something more to like look forward to too. So it's like, there's still gonna be like six more movies coming out.
Exactly. That's what they did with Twilight. Twilight. I mean, there was so much information to happen in that one movie that. That's what the problem is with books that become movies is...
They can leave a lot of stuff out.
Yeah. Well, it just becomes like...
Speaking of the books and everything, what's your like take on that? Like, I hear it's like a satire to like war.
Yeah, like all the books is talking about how all the districts are rebelling against the Capitol. And it kind of has weird similarities with ISIS, with what's going on with ISIS right now. Mm-hmm. So I think that's really interesting.
And also, it's also seen as like the government now is kind of how their government is. Like, they're hiding a lot from their people. They're trying to definitely control and dictate everything that's going on and be an all-powerful source. So
Yeah, and I also heard that, so as she was writing this, she was making it a satire of war. Like, she used children to actually show, like, how stupid she thought it was. Or, like, not stupid, but to, like, put, like, a more of a...
Emphasis?
Yeah, an emphasis on how, like, dangerous and, like, bad war is and everything. Yeah. Well, Del War's bad, but she was trying to make a point to it. But, no, the ISIS relation is really interesting.
Well, exactly with, like, the propaganda, like, with the social media and things like that. Because I know in the third book, what they did, PETA was captured by the Capitol, and they kind of drugged him and kind of made him... brainwashed to say that.
Yeah. Like, no spoilers though. We don't want to like read
it. Read the book. It's in the book.
You didn't hear anything.
But no, that's fine.
Didn't hear it from me.
The first two movies. Did you think those like went pretty well? I'd say.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Better than Twilight, in my opinion.
Oh yeah, for sure.
It was just so much action all the time, and almost I liked the second better than the first, and that never happens in movies for me. I just thought I've really enjoyed the characters and the choice of everything that happened.
Yeah, the casting was perfect. I love the casting.
Like, especially like in Catching Fire and everything. That's whenever we first saw with like Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yeah, he's really good. He's really
bringing that up. Yeah, Philip Seymour Hoffman. He died of a heroin overdose. Yeah. Like.
And he was such a main character in the movie.
He was the
game maker.
Yeah.
And so what they did, they could either use him and kind of like digitally retouch the rest of his parts.
Yeah.
And they didn't want to do that. And so they just...
That'd be disrespectful to his
acting. Exactly. So they rewrote it and they gave his lines to different characters and just kind of eliminated that character from the movie. Which I think was like the most respectful thing to do in that kind of situation.
It's too bad though, because he's such a really good actor.
Yeah, no, yeah.
He's great.
He was a great actor. Okay, guys, well, that's all for this evening. We have No Reels next Tuesday, November 24th. So make sure you tune in the next Tuesday, December 2nd at 6 and 8:30. Thank you guys for watching, and thank you, lovely guest panel. If you guys can't tune in, we are now also doing a YouTube channel with Razorback Reels. Type Razorback Reels 2014 if you want to like check us out. That's cool. but now we're going to leave you with the Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1 trailer. So enjoy.
I never wanted any of this. I never wanted to be in the games. I just wanted to save my sister.
And keep PETA alive.
Miss Everdeen,
It's the things we love most that destroy us.
Everyone who's watching to lay down their weapons now.
You're alive.
PETA is the Capitol's weapon,
the same way you're ours.
You will rescue PETA at the earliest opportunity, or you will find another Mockingjay.